Had to force that one out. This is the helper, this man. Dude, don't snitch. Stop. You heard the lyrics, having a child? Yeah, I already made the joke, though. I can't make it again, guys. It was a good joke. Right off the dome. Is it the crypto joke? No. Uh-oh. Good? It was a good joke. You missed the joke, retell, please. No. No, I don't think so. I don't think I will. Ah! You had to be here, man. You had to be here, dude. Sad to be here, man. Good call, Xenocide. All right, chat. If you own an NFT, DM it to me on Discord, okay? I think someone already did one. Let me see. Let me just hold that shit for a little bit. Bro. People be talking about Control C? Nah, dude. I'm talking ShareX, bookmark, imager.com/yourNFT. And then I'm going to save it. And then I'm going to download it to an external hard drive. I'm going to put that hard drive in a safe somewhere. Hit W in a long ass time. Play music? Nah, this is the just chatting part of the stream, guys. Pretend we're reacting to someone else playing the long drive. Oh, fuck. Yo, chat, what do you think that green light is in the background? Shit, man. That's crazy. Hey, why do you think this guy's not driving on the road? Why not? Don't you go faster on the road? What happens if you crash? Oh my god, did he just fart? Dude, there's farting in this game? No fucking way. Dodge. Wait, is that Sonic.exe? Yo, my kid's been watching Sonic.exe videos, guys. Our TV messed up, and I was like, oh my god, Sonic.exe is in the TV. He's hacking the TV, and he freaked out. He was like, "Oh!" Not like something was coming out of my gas cap. Your kid speaks English? Kinda. Boom, right through the middle, baby. Remount that road. Oh, yeah. Wish I had diesel. I think that engine spawned and then spilled out what was inside of it. Do I really have a kid? Nah, it's just an elaborate joke, guys. Why are you surprised that I have a kid, motherfucker? There's no way you've had sex? Oh, I've had a lot of sex, Switch Chef. Dodge. I'm about to get rocked, I can feel it. I like this. Okay. Really the gameplay people watch nowadays? No, motherfucker, they're watching slots. Motherfucker. And YouTube videos. Dodge. Queen. This guy reminds me of a Reddit comment I read many years ago. It was like, yeah, most personality streamers are fucking cringe. I only go on Twitch to watch real gamers like Shroud. It's fucking Pog. You should see this guy's flicks, they're insane, and then like someone agreeing with him, like, yeah, that's fucking cool. I've never felt more inadequate in my life. Dodge. Be me, looking to improve my gamer skills. Watch someone who's better than me at the game. Profit? Question mark? Bro, stop. Stop lagging. NKPC? Yeah, it's my computer. Oopsie. Man, should I really save it near here? I think so. Wait, mate. Looking fucking poggers, mate. Right fucking pog, mate. That's got the tinted windows. I actually don't like the tinted. It does have this. In it, bruv. You do a gamble. If you will finish this drive tonight or not, I have 250K for the first time. Want to bet against you beating the game tonight. Guys, I can't beat the game tonight. Boom. You know what I just did? I ruined your fucking gains, bitch. Now no one will vote on me beating the game. It's literally impossible for me to beat the game. Food. Help. Hey, broom. Hey, gas. Yeah. We're looking for, like, paint, I think. Take these. Now to remember. Oh, I hit my car. Help! My game's lagging. Just kidding. I mean, the seats are better. Man, don't make me switch, bro. I don't want to move all my shit. Bro, it looks pretty cool, though. Just take the seats. Okay. Ow. Post this ish on TikTok. True, dude. I just watched some guy on Twitch play this game. You won't believe what happened next. Man, would it be that hard to move everything, though? Look, the white stripe's cooler, guys. Well, you've served me well, slightly larger headlight, but now you're dead. Giga basket of hell. Fricky out of this B word. Why do I collect baskets? So I can make it the ultimate creation later. I'm gonna make that plane. Going backwards. You can use two brooms to give your car wings. Broomstick. there a broom up here? Help. I'm at the drive-thru at McDonald's. Press 1 if you want an M&M McFlurry. Oh, shit, bro. Bro, you're not bankrupted today. How do I make it fly with broom? Baskets? Oreo, please? Yeah, I don't know. You can attach brooms in such a way they make it. Yeah, I know. I've already done that, actually. Get out. That works. Bam, bam, bam. I do something like this. Oh. Yeah, that worked. Missed again. How does this work? How does it actually fly, though? Let's get away from this house before I save it. Where'd the road go, bruh? Hey, bruh! Hey, bro, where'd the road go, bruh? We'll be right back. fuck. Ah! You're in danger! Yeah, the road just doesn't load here. What are you doing in there, buddy? Come on out. I don't think I should do this. But I can do this. Dude, stop. Dude, stop. A little bit of roll protection. Wait, which way are we going? Game crashed. Oh, it didn't. We just went through a null void zone. That's my bad. Yeah, we went faster than light, dude. Anyone seen that new Buzz Lightyear movie? I watched it with my kid, who is real. You want to so badly? It's pretty good, I thought, actually. Maybe a little too smart for kids, though. Was he upset about no Tim Allen? Was Tim Allen Buzz Lightyear? Is Tim Allen dead? Why did it get banned in China? Because two women got married? That's why. No, he's Republican, so canceled? Oh. Think about it this way, okay? Does anyone actually give a shit about Tim Allen, all right? Have you seen all of the Santa movies that he was in? Would you call yourself a Tim Allen fan? If he wasn't in quotes canceled, would you even be aware of anything that he was doing right now? But now you're aware that he exists and is repub and has been lay canceled. What if it was all just a marketing scheme? Think about Tim Allen's viewer base, okay? It's boomers, right? Marketing what, though? His existence, man. His cameo. I bet he's on Cameo. Your lib-ass father-in-law loves Tim Allen. Oh, God. Ooh. Bam, 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 bam. Distance travel does not reflect how close we are to our objective, I think. We've taken a lot of shortcuts. Have you seen the Tim Allen Doom mod? Probably. Your dad's a major liberal and like Tim Allen. That's like as of my dad. I think I did tell you what he showed me on YouTube when he was visiting me. How he was following like what was clearly, God, I can't even remember what it is now. It wasn't crypto. But it was like this YouTube channel with these guys that he liked, but like the guys, like everyone commenting on the videos weren't real. There was robots. They'd have like a couple thousand views or whatever, and then like 8 comments, and it was like just random gibberish in the comment section. I'm like, Dad, they're not real, man. They're not real. This isn't real stuff that's happening. No, it wasn't NFTs. Actually, it might have been crypto. I don't know. Damn, I said, my dad is, I call him a poser conservative, okay? Because I know deep down some of the shit that he thinks is, he wouldn't be able to go full mask off, I think. I think he's a poser. Some of the shit that I said to my dad when he was visiting me, we're talking about stuff. If I was still living with him, I'm sure he would have been like, you don't know what the fuck you're talking about, or like something like that. But the shit that I said to him, like, it felt like he was afraid to say something to me. Like, all right, well, that's your opinion. Yeah, like, it was like he no longer could say probably what he would have said 10 years ago. Great story. Maybe he's matured. Yeah, maybe. That's true. For example, the N-word. I don't know. Heard you were talking shit on Krillin? Yeah, fuck Krillin. He's a pussy. He also gets that pussy? No, he doesn't. She's essentially a sex doll. Or at least she was. Zooming right now, bruh. I'm coasting. Yeah, some of the shit that my dad said to me, I was like, you better not say that shit around my wife, dude. She will fucking, he will get angry at you, man. Yeah, my wife does some shit that I'm like, why the fuck would you do that, dude? You said that she was, at the grocery store last week, and I guess she was getting in the car, she just put the kid in, whatever. She sits down, and some fucking 50-something-year-old guy walks up to the car and is like, hey, how was your day? And, like, she was like, oh, good. And then she noticed that she was, that he was wearing a fucking camouflage MAGA hat. And then she was like, she was like, get away from me and don't fucking talk to me. And then she said that the guy looked so sad. He, like, looked down and walked away. I'm like, why the fuck would you... Oh, no! I was like, I would never fucking say that to anyone, dude. Ever, man. I'd say that shit to you after the fact. I was like, yeah, I totally would have said that. You don't know what kind of fucking level of deranged these psychopaths are on. Any psychopath, dude. Not just the camo hat wearing motherfuckers, just out in general, anyway, man. I'm scared, dude. Talking to the feds. People have guns? Yeah, I think Washington's an open carry state or some shit, I forget. Oh, no. So I was reading about that one, and this is probably like a year ago, although I knew about this person for many years, the dude that was pretending to be a superhero in Seattle or whatever. Why did my car stop? Yeah, Phoenix Jones. Washington's an open combat state. Basically, if you agree to, like, fight someone, you can just do it on the street. You can just fucking fist fight someone. I forget what the rules are. Yeah, it's a PvP zone, dude. It was in the documentary about him? Yeah. Both need to agree. But doesn't there need to be, like, someone who's watching or some shit? I forget. Dual enabled state, dude. Seattle only, it has to be monitored by the police. See my headlight. But do I want to get out to pick it up? I already have two good ones. That's kind of dark. Yeah, shut up, pussy. Detroit is like that too, except you need to opt out of the combat. Plenty of people ignore it anyway, though. Huh? Help. My game's lagging. Help. Washington State's one of the only two states in America where mutual combat is totally legal. Yeah, where you at, Texas? You think you're fucking cool? Huh? Loser? Detroit is KOS. I'm not dueling you. Texas also open combat? Oh, shit. Alright. Where are you at, literally every other pussy-ass state? Oh, God. Yeah, I challenged you to a duel at your job about a month ago. You declined. You just hear like the wow jingle when you get challenged to a duel. That's cool, man. When was the last time I got into a fight? Man, it's hard to say. Because I didn't really participate. When I was visiting Adam one time in Virginia Beach, I must have been like 13 or some shit, or 14. Nah, I would have been like 15 or 16, actually. Me, him, his half-brother, and a bunch of his friends arranged a street fight with a bunch of other kids. I remember it being, there was like seven of us on each side. And we literally just like West Side Story walked up to these kids in the middle of the street and just started beating the shit out of each other. But it was pretty amicable after the fact. I guess they had some disagreement. And they decided that fighting was the only way to solve it. And then they fought. And then they were cool with each other afterwards. But I didn't really fight. I just watched. It was in Virginia, Chad. It wasn't Florida, man. I believe you. Thanks. Why the fuck did you bring it up? I don't know. I was technically in that fight. Yeah, I was in the area. Are you mad? I let my friend get stomped out? No. The other time I remember, I was in the first grade and a kindergartner stabbed me with a pencil or a pen at the bus stop and I shoved him over. And he started crying. It's funny because that shit was like, my bus stop was across the street from, literally right across, like 20 steps away from my house. I remember that. I remember waiting to shove this kid until the bus was blocking my mom from view and the bus stop, dude. Fucking push that bitch. That was the only time I ever got in trouble in school. That's not true, actually. I got out of school suspension for either a week or 3 days, and I got my high school parking pass revoked because I was smoking a cigarette in my truck during lunch. On this big-ass fucking parking lot, this fat piece of fucking Florida cop shit was patrolling the tarmac in 105-degree weather, sweating his fucking face off, dude. No, he wasn't in a golf cart, he was walking. Deserved? Yeah, I'm not saying it wasn't deserved. But he, I've told you this story before. He got his drug dog. Ah! That's my job. We have 10K cameras. A patrol high school parking lot. Big man! Big man! So I guess me smoking a cigarette in my truck was probable cause to search my vehicle. They found a cellophane wrapping that had been used to store weed at one point, discarded in the back of my truck. And then this fat motherfucker used like tweezers and a dog to sniff out the tiniest amount of weed and tried to reconstruct the amount of marijuana that he had found inside of the cellophane that he found. But it wasn't even enough for a hit, dude. After like 30 minutes to an hour of this fat piece of shit just going through my car. Maybe don't be a criminal? Yeah, my bad, guys. My bad for having less than a milligram of weed in my truck. Fuck. I am such a criminal! Oh, no! Should have known better. Oh, I did. That's why there wasn't actually enough weed there for me to get in trouble over it. They got me on the cigarettes, boys. Wrangled. I'm trying to drive safe right now, guys. There's a rock! I have to stand there in silence for the whole hour? I mean, I watched him. I really don't remember. I hated that guy, man. He was the most inbred fat piece of shit cop that I ever remember laying eyes upon as a teenager. Holy fuck, he looked inbred. And I know I use that term lightly, okay? But believe me when I say, he looked like fucking Quasimodo, dude. He looked like Gruntilda from Banjo? No. Not that bad. Uh-oh. Okay. The kilometers on my thing aren't exactly correct. Because we got this car later. And I think it had miles on it already. I just don't remember how many. Slow down. I'm afraid to drive off-road in the grass, man. I ain't trying to dizzy Brizzo. You can see on the save game how much you've driven? How come this says 2,000 cams, which I know it was only in triple digits when we first got it, and my save file says 500 cam? Wait, it's 200? No, it's not. Yes, it is. Guys, I'm legally blind without glasses. Oh, it's miles, not kilometers. Oh, you're right. Yeah, in this car, it's miles, which is good for us. Gonna drink some of this later. The jizz. Boom. Would look good if I had more black paint. Bam, 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 bam. Man. So before all this ACAB shit and the fucking Black Lives Matter stuff really kicked off, I remember one time I was driving with my wife. And I'm not calling my wife a bootlicker by any means. Okay. But I got pulled over by there's a space on the highway where it's like the speed limit is like 70, I think, and then it goes down to like 45 for less than a mile, okay, and then it's back up to 70, and it was the end of the month, and there's this motherfucking state trooper with like was that's, man, I wish I could describe the spot that he was in, dude. He got me on a speed trap, and it's like at a place that it is so fucking insane that he, like, the way he did it. He got me. And I was so mad. I was so fucking mad. Because just, like, you know, yeah, I was speeding. Yes, I was. I was going, like, I must have been, like, going 60 in this 45 zone or 65 or some shit. It's still the highway. Let me be clear about that. It's not going through a residential area. Nothing like that, guys. And the guy knows he got me. Okay. So when he, you know, he's like, he comes and gets my information, blah, blah, blah. And my wife was like, why are you so mad? You were speeding. I told you not to speed. You were speeding. It's your fault. I'm like, okay, yeah, okay, all right. The cop comes back. That's felony speeding, guys. Okay. That's felony speeding. But he comes back, and he gives me the charge for like going like 10 over or some shit. I forget. Because he knew he got me. And a very like, and I wasn't nice to this guy. I didn't suck up to him or nothing when he walked up. I was like, all right, here's my info, blah, blah, blah. He came back and he gave me a big break, I guess. For whatever reason. But I was very, very, and the whole reason I'm telling the story is because of my experience with the school cop when I was a teenager, right? I've never had a good experience with a cop, really, at the end of the day. That's not true, actually. I had one good experience with a cop. It was when I was streaming GTA roleplay, and I met a retired cop. I think he was like a sergeant or some shit. And I took my kid to the park, and he was there with his grandkid or some shit, and we talked. It was alright. But, at that point, I was learning how to do cop shit. So I asked him a lot of questions and stuff about his job. Shit like that. because I was genuinely interested in it. What is this road? Did I tell him why? Yeah, I did. I did. And he was like, what? He kind of laughed at me a little bit. I'm almost beyond shame, so I didn't feel bad. I was like, all right. Where the fuck? We gotta find a better route than the road. Guys don't have any headlights. Wait, we need to go back to the house. But yeah, the whole reason I tell that speeding story is because my wife was like, oh, he's just doing his job. He's just doing his job, blah, blah, blah. This motherfucker wouldn't say that shit about a cop nowadays, though. I'll tell you that right now. This isn't a house. It's a fucking garage. Literally is? Yeah, he was doing his job. He sure was, guys. He sure fucking was. You're right. You're not wrong about that. Whoa, there's like nothing in here. I'm just glad my wife's on the same wavelength with me when it comes to the police. So you gaslit her enough? No. No. What's up? Gaslit about what? Hey, a headlight. I need that. So I know back of the blue. Bro, when does the blue back me, dog? When does the blue back me? Oh, man. I know you better not call the cops for anything, then. Look, man. I that is the common response to that, but listen, I probably wouldn't anyway. Oh my god, there's someone breaking into my house! Why would I get on my phone to call the police before I'm sure that my family and I are safe? No, there are other things that need to be done first before that. I don't know. What other scenario would I need to call the cops in? Why is my car swerving? Help! To be a Karen? Car was stolen? It would be very hard to steal my car, I think. That's not true, actually. Call the cops on super loud neighbors? Well, that's not an issue. Like, I did call the cops semi-recently to report a homeless woman that was walking in the middle of the road at night with a shopping cart. I almost fucking ran her ass over, dude. Does that count, Chatter, who said, well, you better not go to cop? Yeah. Snitch? Dude. Like, who gets in trouble for that? Like, surely I don't get in trouble if I run over this homeless person who is wearing all black, no reflector lights, walking in the middle of the fucking road. I didn't. I had to swerve, dog. It was scary. called 911 a month or two ago because your neighbor was outside deliberately lighting his and his neighbor's lawns on fire with a drip torch. I think I just shot my gun. Huh? Look, one of the things that when I was talking to that cop at the park, told me, he was like, yeah, I don't regret being a cop. It's kind of fucked up the shit that's happening nowadays with like abuse of power and whatnot. He told me, bro, I would never ever in a million years become a cop in current day. And he told me, the only reason I became a cop is because of like how fucking cool it looked in like TV shows and movies and all this shit when I was growing up as a kid. And this guy must have been like 50 or 60 years old or some shit. But he was like, bro, I would never be a cop today because he said to me, they get no respect. I was like, yeah, that's true. That's true, man. True. Through that. You got copagandized, dude. Bro, I don't like getting pulled over. And it doesn't happen often, okay? But there's just always in the back of your mind, you're like, this guy's got a gun. I'm scared. I need to make sure that my hands are visible at all times. What if I sneeze? Is this guy gonna fucking plaster my brains over the dashboard? Is he having a bad day? Am I gonna die? Is this the last straw for this guy? Am I gonna say the wrong thing that teeters this fucking high school dropout over the edge? Yeah, he's not gonna get in trouble. Probably. They're white? I know, that's... Dude! I know. I know, man. But I feel scared every time. Every time I interact with a cop, I'm always nervous. Every time. And that's because I've been taught to be nervous. But it's the same way, it's really just the gun thing for me. Like them having a gun and me not having a gun. My best friend came to visit me in North Carolina. He's got a concealed carry because he was in the military. Yeah. I have no problem with it, but I'd literally never seen him with a gun before, ever. So I was kind of weirded out about it. I don't know. I didn't have a gun at the time. Fucking, I was like, do you mind putting your gun in your car downstairs? And he was like, sure, man. That wasn't an issue. That was when I was still a little gun shy, though. Now it probably wouldn't bother me. Bam, bam, bam. Truck? Truck? That's not a truck. That is a car with a trailer on top of it. Why? I know you don't live in Texas just by that. Well, Washington's also you can open carry in Washington. Pretty sure. Blood? What happens when you drink blood? Yeah, you can PvP too, but not with gun. Just read a paragraph. I'm not gonna read it out loud. That was funny though. Buy your kid a BB gun? Nah. My kid's Like, I wrestle with my kitten shit, but I'm worried he's getting a little too roughhousey. I watched him punch my wife in the face the other day, dude. Holy fuck. He'll be a football prodigy? Yeah. He had a very serious talking to after that. Damn, this car's in, like, perfect condition. The tires are in perfect condition? You tell him that better form? No, I said, what up, Top G? Said, what up? What's good? Trade the tires? You know, it might be safer to trade the tires because they're smaller, which means our top speed will top out at a safer speed. So you want to go slower because you a coward?
Yeah.
You have hella speeding tickets. Why do you care about being safer? I haven't gotten a speeding ticket in many years, guys. I was getting roadhead from my girlfriend in high school and I got a speeding ticket one time. Well, it wasn't a speeding ticket, it was a fucking seatbelt citation. That come? No, roadhead sucks, guys. It's not good, man. I was going like 35 through a school zone or some shit. And this cop saw as I was driving by that I didn't have my seatbelt on or some shit. So he like cut me a break because he knew I was a teenager. Instead of giving me the speeding ticket, he gave me the seatbelt citation or whatever. No, he didn't see it. He didn't see the roadhead. Roadhead sucks, man. Who's ever successfully finished as a result of roadhead? I don't think. That number's gotta be low, man. What the fuck would you drive with a guillotine on your dick? Look, man. I was living dangerously, man. You're right, though. He's right. Why would you do that? Make a girl drive and suck my dick at the same time? How is that possible? What the fuck did I hit? Huh? I collided with the road. car looks cool, bro. On Jesus. Dude, my radiator. First car I ever owned? I mean, the first car that was entrusted to me was my dad's old F-150. Totaled that. Took a while, though. It was like 1994 or F-150 or some shit. How? God, how did I total it? Oh. I was listening to music really fucking loud. And I was like in a median trying to cross over the right lane of traffic. Some dude in a tiny ass fucking car was in my blind spot, and I just like started to accelerate as he was driving past me, and his car turned sideways in front of my truck. Fucking, I pitted this dude. Didn't run him over, fortunately. It's not the wrong way. Most terrifying driving experience? One time